So here's our tab view in action. We just tap on a tab and you can see our tab number changes and we get a nice animation between tabs. So let's go ahead and get started by creating a new Xcode project, picking iOS and calling it something like custom tabs and save where you like. And here we are greeted with our typical hello world view. We're gonna go ahead and just delete this and Command Shift L. And inside here, we're just gonna type in tab space V. And we get our default tab view by just double tapping or pressing enter. Nothing too fancy here. Tab 1 and tab 2, you can see down here on the bottom right, there's the first tab. Go here, go to the next tab. Missing the images, but this is the default tab. Go ahead and modify this to make our own custom tab view. So let's go ahead and get started with that by deleting this line here and just pressing enter. And then I'm going to just go ahead and delete that. So our tab bar is now gone, and we're going to also modify the selection here by just coming up to line 10, pressing enter a few times. And on line 11 here, we're going to go at state, and this is going to be a private variable, so var, and we're going to call it tab selection, like so. And we're just going to assign it a value of 1. We could assign it to any value, but we're going to just have it the first tab in our tab array. We're basically going to have an array of these tabs. And then for tab view selection, we're just going to go $tab selection. We're just going to select line 15 and 16 here, and I'm just going to go Command C, go Enter, Command V, Enter, Command V. And we're going to do this one more time. Just change these numbers to 2, 3, 4, 5, and make sure we update our tags as well as 2, 3, 4, and 5. Next, we want to go ahead and add an overlay here. And this is going to be where we're going to be placing our new specialized tab bar. So we're going to go dot overlay. And here we're going to specify the alignment. So alignment, and then it's going to be bottom, and then we'll go tab, enter, actually delete that. We'll just go to the end of the line, open curly brace, enter, that'll close it for us. And here's where we're going to create our custom tab view. So what are we going to put here? Well, let's go ahead and come up here and create a new file. This will just be a SwiftUI file. We'll go next, and we're going to call it custom tab view because don't know what else to call it. And here we go, a basic hello world view. But we're gonna build it out and make it really nice. So the first thing we're gonna do before we build out the view, is gonna enter a few lines, and we're gonna add in two properties and an array. So I guess three properties. So here on line 11, we have a binding to our tab selection, which we'll get from the content view. Then we have this namespace, which we're gonna use for animation in a little bit. And then here, we have an array of tuples. So just a tuple here. I'm not going to make it a special object because I just want to image a string and a title. Now we could make special objects and do more, which probably what we would do if we were building out more complex app, but this is good for now. And of course it's not happy that we didn't pass in the binding here. So we're just going to go dot constant. And we're going to give it a value of 1. Command S, Command B, and I think we're good. Build succeeded. So let's go ahead and start on line 23 by deleting this view. And we're going to make a Z stack here and open, close curly brace. And we're going to add one modifier to this view, which is going to be dot padding. And we're going to specify that we just want to add padding to the horizontal and not all around or vertical or anywhere else. Now I think we're pretty good to just start writing all the rest of the code here in our Z stack. So on line 24, we're going to go ahead and create a capsule, which is going to be kind of the backdrop of our whole custom tab. We could use a rounded rect, a rectangle, a custom shape, really anything we want. Just going to open and close parentheses there to take care of that problem. And then we're going to add a few more modifiers, because if I option Command P and update our preview, you'll see the capsule takes up the entire view. So let's go ahead and modify that by going dot frame. And then inside of our frame, we do want to specify the height, which I'm going to say is 80. That's looking pretty good. One thing I like to do is scroll down here a bit, and on our preview, let's go dot preview layout dot size that fits. Doesn't look like it changed anything, but if I come down here and I tap selectable, we now have a preview that shows us just what we're working on. Just for preview purposes though, I do want to add some vertical padding here, so we're going to go dot vertical. And that just lets us look at the view not as squished or contained inside of our little preview box. Back to line 25, and we'll go ahead and hit enter, and we're going to add two modifiers. One is going to be for our foreground color, and this is going to be color, open parentheses, dot secondary system background. So the color for content layered on top of the main background. Now that looks really light. So our second modifier, or third, is going to be dot shadow, and we're going to give it a radius of 2. That looks a little better. I think it looks best in dark mode, but really just depends on colors and schemes and how much of a designer you are. Go ahead and feel free to make this whatever you like. The next thing we're going to make in our Z stack is an H stack. This is going to be kind of the main component. And inside of our H stack, we want to create a for each for the buttons. So we're going to go for each, and then we're going to open parentheses, and we're going to go from 0 less than 5. We want to create some index like so, even though I should add some spacing there. And these indices will be matched up with our numbers in our content view. So back here, these 1, 2, and so forth. It's kind of what we're going to match up to. So we'll go ahead and start creating the button. Open parenthesis AC, action label, hit enter. And the action for this is going to be changing our tab selection. And we'll be doing that by assigning it our index plus 1. So if they tap the first button, it'll be 1. If they tap the second button, it'll be 2, and so forth. We're getting some complaints right now, but we'll fix that now by just tabbing and going VStack. And we're going to go open parenthesis, spacing. And we're going to set our spacing to 8, just kind of make things not as tight. So play with this number, get what you would like to see visually, and go from there. Now with that in place, we're also just going to add a spacer on top. And you can see once we added that spacer, we got all this space here, which isn't exactly what we're going for. So clean up this little space here. We'll scroll down. We'll look at our H stack. And I think what I want to do here is give it a frame modifier as well. Open parenthesis and spell out height. And we're going to give it an 80. And I didn't mean to put min height there, so we'll just go H. And now we've got a V stack that has the same height as our capsule background. So that's looking pretty good. Now back to our V stack on line 35. Go ahead and enter a few times. Give us a little space. And we're going to go ahead and create an image. And we're going to do that by going image, open parenthesis, system. And then in here, we're not going to just put in some string. We're going to go tab bar items, which is that array of tuples we made earlier. We hit enter there, and then we open parenthesis and pass in the current index that we're on. And then we can go image to access the image for that index. And you can see we have our home, our search, our favorites, and so on. This isn't looking amazing at the moment, but we're going to fix that as we build it out the rest of the way. Enter again a few times, and we're going to add some text. So we're going to go text, and we're going to go open parenthesis, tab bar items again, and again we'll be accessing the current index we're on, and from there we're going to go ahead and go dot title. With all that in place, we want to now start working on adding the capsule at the bottom that kind of follows our tabs around when you tap on them. So enter a few times, and let's scroll down a little bit so we can see what we're doing. And here we're going to use a conditional statement because we don't want our tab or a capsule to show up on every single tab. We want it to be on one at a time based on a certain condition. So the condition here is going to be index, and we're going to see the index plus one is equal to our tab selection. Then we're going to go open curly brace, enter, and then we're going to go ahead and create another capsule. A lot of capsules in this tutorial. So hopefully you like the shape. We're going to go ahead and add the frame to this, and we're going to specify the height. And this one's going to be pretty small. It's just going to be 8. You can see our capsule's getting built out right there. And we want to set the foreground color for it, .foreground color. And this is going to be .blue. But again, you could do any color you wanted. Next, we want to go ahead and add our match geometry effect to it. And this is where we're going to be using that namespace. So .matchedGeometryEffect. And it says defines a group of views with a synchronized geometry using an identifier and a namespace that you provide. So we can imagine some different objects that we specify with certain IDs, and we can animate smoothly between those two objects as if they were one. I think that's a good description. I don't know. Let me know in the description, the comment section below. We're just going to give this ID, or maybe even selected tab ID would probably be more descriptive. And for our namespace, we already created that. So let's go tab, and we'll go namespace. And I think, yep, we called it animation namespace. Kind of a generic name. Perhaps we should have came up with something better on that one. But good enough for now. Another thing we want to do is if you're looking at our tab here, this capsule, I kind of want it to be down a little bit so we don't see the bottom curve, just the top. So let's do that by giving it a dot offset. And then we'll just offset it in the Y direction. And we're going to give it an offset of 3. That's looking pretty good. Again, it's coming out of the view and there's a few other little problems, but we're going to get to that momentarily. Let's finish up this code here, because we do need one more part of this, and that is going to be an else statement. So let's go ahead and complete that. Scroll down a little bit, because if we move between these, it's going to mess up and they're going to be bouncing kind of up and down. So let's go ahead and go capsule. We're going to give it the same frame. So dot frame, open parenthesis height, a min height, and we're going to fix that to just height. They're not quite right because this one doesn't have a offset, which we'll fix that momentarily. We're going to go first, we're going to go foreground, and we're going to set the foreground color to be clear. So now we don't even see them. So let's go dot offset, Y, and again 3, just to get these lined up a little better. Now, one of the things we're having problems with is you can see that this capsule is sitting out here and over here, and it doesn't look great. So we're going to go ahead and add a clip shape right before our padding over here. We'll do that by coming here and going dot clip shape. And for our clip shape, we're just going to use a capsule. Like I said, a lot of them in this tutorial. Now it cuts it out, making the UI look a little more polished, hopefully. Another thing we want to modify is all these are blue, and we really want to bring some attention to the one that the user's currently on. Obviously, that's why we have this little bar that's going to follow along, but we could also do it with some color. So let's go ahead. If you close up our, and if you go to the bottom of our VStack here on line 53, we can go ahead and do that by going dot foreground color, and we can use a ternary operator here. So basically we check the index plus one is equal to tab selection. If it is, go ahead and make it dot blue. Otherwise, make it dot gray. Not green, gray. Even though you could make it green if you'd like. Hopefully this brings a little bit more attention to our currently selected tab. And with that in place, we should be able to go back to our content view, scroll down to line 31. Let's get this whole view to fit first. And then we can just go custom tab view, the one we built out ourselves, open parenthesis, and we want a binding to our tab selection, so $tab selection. And there you go. We should now be able to move across our tab, other than the fact that that is not looking smoothly animated. And I think we messed up on our padding a little bit. Sometimes I've noticed the animation doesn't work so good in the canvas, but it seems to work better in the simulator. We'll do that in the custom tab view. So to clean up the problem here with the sizing, that was just, we need to modify the font. So we'll go ahead and dot font, and we're gonna go ahead and add dot caption. Make things a little smaller and everything fits in our tab bar here. And if we run it again, looks a lot better. We tap on something, our little bar slides between what we've tapped on, and doesn't look too bad. Let me know in the comments below. Would you use custom tabs in your apps, or is it best just to stick with the default that we get from Apple? Thanks for watching. Until next time, share and enjoy.